I think about the need for us to establish our own beauty standards. But I've always had the thought that without representation, you're left seeking validation.
Which era were you guys like super fans of? I know which one it was for me, but I want to know which one it is for you guys. Which era did you just love everything about? The clothes, the fashion, the hair, the makeup? Come on, tell me.
If I had to think of a point in time where I was just really crushing on and stanning Black women, it would absolutely be the 70s. I feel like self-expression was at an all-time high in the 70s. Also, like, the Black and Proud movement was such a thing. I just felt like there was such pride in being exactly who you were in the 70s, and so I stan Black women in the 70s.
The 90s. Because the 90s were a jam, okay? We were bopping and grooving, and women were keeping up with the men, and, you know, 90s brings me back to when I was being raised and dance and all of that, those vibes and the good music and stuff. So I think of Black women killing it because they were my inspirations, you know? I was looking up to all of these amazing Black women in the 90s.
The 60s. I adore the 60s. The music, Motown, the hair, the dresses, the makeup, everything about it. I loved how women, like, it just seemed like they held themselves in a different way. And everything was so just put together. I love that look.
When I was younger, growing up, my role model and idol has and always has been and still is my mom.
Which is such a cute and also cheesy thing to say, but it's true. Like, my mom raised me by herself, at one point worked two jobs, at one point worked midnights, and like, my mom was just a really hard worker, and I think it's what taught me work ethic.
My mom has been with me through everything in my career. She's been my number one fan and stuff, and it's just amazing, but she's always been my idol, and I'm always just like, I'm right there with her, you know?
I absolutely stan for Nana Gwen, Nana Pam, Mama Jody, and all the women in my family, because they all went through everything that they needed to go through and things that they may have experienced that I might not have, but they went through that so that they could tell me, impart their wisdom, and pass it down. My Nana is my dad's mom, and she has these beautiful beauty marks and freckles all along her face, all over, and she got more and more of them as the years went by. And so for me to see that and see it transferred, I guess, to me, just made me feel really happy. Like, oh, that's a part of me too.
Black is the new black, you know? It is everything right now. The culture, the people, style. I like seeing everybody come together, support the community and the culture the way that we have been, and celebrating it.
When I think about the beauty industry and just Black women in general, I think about the need for us to establish our own beauty standards. But I've always had the thought that without representation, you're left seeking validation. So I'm excited that the beauty industry is changing. I'm excited that diversity is in right now. I hope that it's not a trend, but I'm excited that more women are starting to see themselves within the beauty industry, regardless of your race, your shape, your hair texture, your size, like, all of those things contribute to how a woman looks and feel about herself. And so my goal has always been to uplift women in our many facets of life. Like, that's always been my goal.
I love that go? Dang, Melissa just make me cry in the middle of this beauty segment. We're really able to see the companies and the people that are like, come one, come all, please. Come just as you are. We accept you just like you are. You can rock this just like you are. It doesn't matter. And I think that that is where we gotta stay right there. Inclusive to everyone.
Okay, ladies, I wanna make a toast. This one is for all of the women who have paved the way for us. All of our role models, our icons, our legends. This is for you.
Come on, ladies.
Cheers.
Mm.